Welcome to the Oregon State College of Engineering. You're about to embark on an exciting journey of exploration and discovery. Plenty of companions will join you on your adventure. You'll be immersed in a community of motivated, intellectually curious peers from all walks of life and from many cultures. You'll make lifelong friends, and together you'll learn skills that prepare you for a successful career and a rewarding life. From start to finish, your teachers and mentors will be there to support you. Your education starts in the classroom, but it doesn't end there. You'll have opportunities to work alongside renowned researchers in the lab and in the field. Internships with industry leaders will give you the kind of hands-on experience that brings your classroom to life and that is prized by employers. Be sure to check out our many student organizations and clubs, where you'll meet students with similar interests and explore everything that engineering has to offer. When you graduate, you'll carry away much more than a diploma. Whatever your degree, you'll leave with technical mastery and a solid foundation of practical and theoretical knowledge. You'll follow in the footsteps of the growing legion of graduates who have ventured out to leave their marks on their profession, their communities, and beyond. But don't just take our word for it. They'll tell you themselves.
The most exciting part about my field is that I am centrally involved with human exploration of space. And not only do I help in the engineering design and the operations of our spacecraft, but I'm also one of the crew members that get to fly into space. I gained from OSU a strong foundation in the basics, the axioms, not operating from recitation, but from understanding engineering, understanding the world around us from the axioms so that you can see something that you haven't necessarily had a homework problem on and figure out what to do.
So my undergraduate experience in nuclear engineering at Oregon State was really important. The first thing is it gave me a really good technical background and a really good technical education. But the second thing that we had was a smaller department. And what that enabled was a kind of a family feel to the department and the people that I went through school with. What I learned from that was how to collaborate, how to work in a team. And that collaborative spirit that the professors instilled in me and that my fellow students instilled in me is what I'm using today, every day in my job in this multidisciplinary environment that I work in.
So I currently work for Tillamook County Creamery Association. We make delicious cheese, ice cream, yogurt, and butter. I'm a manager of project management. I think one of the greatest skills that I acquired while I was here at Oregon State was really simple, but problem solving. So how do we make a clear problem statement? What is it that we're trying to do? And then what do we need to solve that? Who do we need? Trade-off discussions of different different scenarios that we might have, but being able to go through that process myself and lead a team through a problem-solving framework has served me well in many situations.
I started off my career doing bridge design, bridge load rating, but over the last 10 years I've begun to specialize in bridge inspection. Probably the highlight of my career came last spring when we did an inspection on the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. And that involved a team of 24 people, and part of it was inspecting the towers. So that involved walking up the cables up to an elevation of about 750 feet above the bay and then rappelling down the towers. And I'll be honest, I was a little nervous at the time, but it was one of the most exhilarating things I've ever done, and just happy to have been a part of that team. The biggest thing I learned, I think, at OSU was how to think analytically. You know, I like to say when somebody comes out with an undergraduate degree, you know, you've learned how to think like an engineer. So I think it was the ability to think analytically that paved the way for the field that I'm in now. I'd have to say another big part is working as a team, learning to work with other people. If you have difficulty working with the team and with others, it would be a struggle in this industry. So a lot of our projects at Oregon State revolved around working in a team and collaborating, and that's what we do every day.
When I started university, my skill set was a little bit behind. I didn't have the technology skills I needed to be successful.
particularly as an individual with blindness, and I also didn't have the skills to advocate for myself. All the professors and faculty were endlessly supportive in using their resources to make sure I would be successful. So I think it was almost a survival instinct of wanting to be better than what I had been taught to believe I was capable of. While I was at Oregon State, I used to train for marathons. So I had coffee with a friend of mine, and he dared me to do an Ironman. So I signed up for an Ironman, not knowing what it was. And then I had to train like crazy. I'd never swam, I had to learn to swim. I was the first blind female to have ever done an Ironman with a female guide. That got a lot of press. So I had the opportunity to do an Ironman with a professional female who was a hero of mine. I won the world record for fastest blind and low vision Ironman distance for males and females. And then from there, I was recruited to the U.S. national team